Hello friends, welcome to Club Craft Area. If you are new to this channel, subscribe my channel by clicking the subscribe and bell button to get more videos. In this video, we are going to see how to do the basics of knitting using crochet hook, that is cast on, knit stitch and bind off. For this, I am using yarn and two crochet hooks. These two crochet hooks should be of same mm. So I have used two 4 mm crochet hooks. So now let's see how to do them. To start, first we have to make a slip knot. Wrap the yarn over the finger and place one end of the yarn over the other yarn. Take the other end of the yarn and place it like this. Take this loop and pull the yarn like this. So this is the slip knot. Insert the hook in the slip knot. So for knitting, the slip knot is also considered as first stitch. While we are doing crochet, after doing a slip knot, we'll be doing the foundation chain. In knitting, the foundation chain is known as cast on. So now we'll see how to do them. These stitches should be loose so that it will be easy to work with the other hook. So first, to do the cast on, same way how we wrap the yarn for this slip stitch, we have to wrap the yarn over the finger, turn the finger like this, insert the hook in this loop and remove the finger. So this is the next stitch. Same way, wrap the yarn over the fingers, turn it like this and insert the hook in this loop, then remove the finger. 3. Wrap the yarn over the finger, turn it like this, insert the hook in this loop and remove this finger. Wrap the yarn over the finger, turn like this, insert the hook in this loop and remove the finger. Wrap the yarn over the finger, turn the finger, insert the hook in this loop and remove the finger. So for practice, I'll be doing 10 loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So this slip stitch will be counted as the first loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now we have completed the first step, which we say it as cast on. Next, we are going to do the next stitch. For that, turn this hook facing you. Take the next hook in the next hand. And to do the knit stitch, the working yarn should come at the back. So we'll be catching them like this. Catch like this and we'll catch the hook like this. So next we'll be working with this stitch. We'll be inserting this hook in this loop so that this working yarn is at the back and this hook is in front, and yarn over, pull through the loop and we'll remove this loop from this hook. So we have finished one stitch. Same way, insert the hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through and remove the stitch. Same way, insert the hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the stitch and we'll remove the stitch from the hook. Insert the hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the stitch and remove the stitch. Insert the hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the loop and we'll remove the stitch. So if you insert the hook in the next stitch, it will be like this, yarn over, pull through the loop and we'll remove this loop. So we have to do this till you reach the last stitch. So it looks like this. So now we have transferred all the loops which were in this hook to the next hook. We need to be careful that we always have 10 loops on the hook which we started. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So for next round, turn the hook facing yourself. Take the working yarn at the back side. Take the hook in the next hand. And we have to do the same thing. Insert the hook in this loop so that it looks like this. This working yarn is at the back and the hook is in the front. Yarn over, pull through the loop and pull this loop from the hook. Push the loop little bit in front. Insert the hook in the next loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Next, push the hook little bit in front so that the loops become little loose. It will be easy to insert the hook in this loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the next loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Push it little bit. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the hook from the loop. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. So we have completed the second round. So you have to follow the same process. So for next round, turn the hook facing yourself. Take the working yarn in the other hand. Bring it at the back of the hook. Place it like this. Take the next hook in the other hand. We have to insert the hook. So in such a way, it is like this. And the working yarn is at the back. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. And bring the loops in front little bit. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop in the hook. This is the process which we want to do till the required length we want. So if you see, we have finished the next round. This is what we say it as knit stitch. So you have to follow the same pattern. Turn the hook facing yourself. Take the next hook in the hand. Take this working yarn in the other side of the hook. Bring the loops little bit closer and insert the hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. So you have to continue this till you reach the end. We have to sure that this working yarn is at back of this hook. So you have completed with the next row. So this is what we say it as knit stitch. I'll catch you back after doing some more rows of this knit stitch. And we'll see how to do the bind off. After doing some rows of knit stitch, it looks like this. So next we'll see how to do the bind off. So next, turn it like this way. Take this yarn at the back. Insert this hook in the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. Insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. So we'll have two loops on the hook. Next we'll be doing the slip stitch how we do in the crochet. That is, we'll pull this second loop through this first loop. Looks like. So next, insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and pull the loop from the hook. You will have two loops on the hook. Insert the second loop through this first loop like this. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and pull the loop from the hook. You will have two loops on the hook. We will insert the second loop through this first loop. We'll do a slip stitch like this. Next, insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and pull the loop from the hook. You'll have two loops on the hook. So we'll insert this second loop through this first loop like this. So this is what we say it as bind off. That is, insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and pull the loop from the hook. You'll have two loops on the hook and pull the second loop through the first loop. Insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and pull the loop from the hook. You'll have two loops on the hook and you'll insert the second loop through the first loop. Insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop, remove the loop from the hook. You'll have two loops on the hook and pull the second loop through the first loop. Insert the hook in the next loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the loop from the hook. You'll have two loops on the hook and pull the second loop through the first loop. Insert the hook in the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop and remove the hook from the loop. You'll have two loops on the hook and pull the second loop through the first loop. So this is what we say it is binding. This is how it looks like. Next you can do chain one and you can snip off this yarn. This is how the knit stitch looks when we use two crochet hook. So if you like this video, like, share, comment this video and also subscribe to my channel by clicking the subscribe and bell button to get more videos. Thank you, friends.